Support WrestleTalk!
Give us a subscribe.
Thank you for being an awesome pledgehammer on Patreon, WrestleTalk's personal ring announcer, Rodrigo Benitez.
Hello and welcome to the WrestleTalk News. I'm Ollie Davis, and today's episode is sponsored by The Ridge. The Ridge make innovative minimalist wallets, which don't just save space in your pocket for smartphone devices. Its RFID blocking technology protects you from bad guys skimming your credit card details remotely, where they can hack your card's contactless chip to steal your information. But not with The Ridge, you can't, villain! We actually like them so much here at WrestleTalk, we've even replaced our old wallets with them. And with a lifetime guarantee, The Ridge could be the last wallet you ever buy. So go over to ridge.com/WrestleTalk by clicking the link in the video description below and use the discount code WrestleTalk to get not just 10% off your order, but also free worldwide shipping. It's very important you use that link as we love The Ridge and want to do more with them, but they need to see the SWAF Nation are into it too.
Thanks, Ollie. Even while on holiday, you can still remind us of how great The Ridge is, somehow. In case you've been living under a rock or sheltering yourself from the wrestling world, you'll know that there was an absolute ton of wrestling this past weekend, with AEW's third show, Fight for the Fallen, Evolve's 10th anniversary show airing on the WWE Network, more days of New Japan's G1 Climax, and WWE's Extreme Rules last night. Unfortunately for a lot of wrestlers, with that much major wrestling comes a major risk, and as such, there were quite a few injuries picked up over the weekend. To begin with, Dr. Britt Baker reportedly suffered a concussion at AEW's Fight for the Fallen on Saturday. Baker was in a tag match on the buy-in pre-show, teaming with Riho in a losing effort against Shoko Nakajima and the debuting Bea Priestley. It's unclear when the injury took place, but Baker posted on Twitter that a co-worker looked after her all night when taking her to the hospital following a concussion, and she'd replaced the pair of earrings that the co-worker had unfortunately lost. That is some wholesome content right there. If Baker is indeed injured, then WrestleTalk would like to wish her a speedy recovery. Another injury picked up at the same show, but on the main show this time, was for one MJF. MJF teamed with Shawn Spears and Sammy Guevara to take on Jimmy Havoc, Joey Janela, and Darby Allin, but MJF's trio were actually victorious. During the course of the match, it seems MJF picked up an elbow injury. MJF was scheduled to appear at last night's Inspire Pro Wrestling event, but he was pulled to prevent any further injury. Unfortunately for the promotion, MJF was also the Pure Prestige champion, which he's now been forced to vacate. Inspire put out a series of tweets explaining the situation. At approximately 4:07 this morning, Inspire Pro was delivered the unfortunate news that Pure Prestige champion Maxwell Jacob Friedman sustained a severe elbow injury at last night's Fight for the Fallen event. With MJF scheduled to appear at next week's Triple Mania, the decision was made to pull him from tonight's event to prevent any further injury. Therefore, MJF will not be defending his Pure Prestige Championship tonight against Ricky Starks, with MJF soon to become exclusive to AEW. The opportunity to reschedule the match is not possible. Therefore, MJF and Inspire have come to a mutual agreement to vacate the Pure Prestige title. Caps lock aside, from the wording of the tweets, it would seem that the elbow injury in question seems pretty severe. However, it's been further clarified by Sean Ross Sapp of Fightful that the injury is not too serious and that him pulling out of the event was a precautionary measure to not aggravate it further ahead of his AAA appearance, where he'll be tagging with Cody Rhodes. WrestleTalk would like to wish MJF a speedy recovery, as always. The injury train doesn't stop there, though. That's a weird thing to say, as one of New Japan's top stars also picked up an injury during the G1 Climax. The G1 Climax continued this weekend, with Will Ospreay picking up his first victory over Sanada. Ospreay had previously lost to Lance Archer, but it's looking like he won't be able to continue his momentum as New Japan's official Twitter accounts sent out tweets stating that Ospreay suffered a neck injury. Will Ospreay will miss tonight's G1 29 event due to injury. Ospreay is not suffering from any skeletal or nervous issues. His status for July 18th will be determined after thorough medical evaluation. Ospreay then followed up this himself with a tweet saying, "Sorry I couldn't make it out there, guys. I'm in a huge amount of pain right now, but New Japan is giving me all the best treatment and taking great care of my health. I'll do my best to continue the G1. While neck issues can spell big trouble for wrestlers, it's good to know that he's not suffering from any skeletal or nervous problems, which would probably indicate the injury is muscular in nature, which can be healed given enough rest. WrestleTalk would like to wish Will Ospreay a speedy recovery and the best of luck should he return to the G1. Finally, we can stop talking about injuries because we've got something much more juicy on our hands. The omnipresent, omniscient, omnipotent CM Punk. Last night at Extreme Rules, we saw the Graveyard Dogs team up to take on the best in the world, Shane McMahon and Drew McIntyre, with the Graveyard Dogs picking up the win. Extreme Rules took place in Philadelphia, PA, and Philadelphia 76ers Communications Vice President Dave Schuller tweeted about the lovely seats he got in the arena, including a picture of Roman Reigns and The Undertaker standing tall over Shane McMahon lying flat on his back. CM Punk would respond to the tweet in a now-deleted tweet, saying, "Is that a fan that jumped in the ring?" Shane has of course been using CM Punk's signature "Best in the World" moniker for some time now, and it seems like he's not quite over it. Don't worry, Punk. You'll just have to show them up by appearing at AEW's All Out in Chicago. CM Punk to AEW confirmed. Have you checked out the second week of Screenstalker's new content? We talk about gamer girl bathwater and so much more. Click the video to my right to be taken to that video right now. Make sure to get your copy of the WrestleTalk Almanac using the link below as well. A special thank you to our pledge hammers on Patreon, some of whom you can see scrolling below me right now. Press the thumbs up, subscribe, and bell icons before you go though, and leave us a comment too. I've been Chopper Pete Quinnell, and that was wrestling.